Hi everybody and welcome back to Relax My Cat. Now for today's video, me and Miu here, we're going to be going through several different cat breeds and what their common health issues are. Now first I want to say that just because if your cat breed is under this and you haven't had, your cat hasn't had this health issue, I won't particularly worry about it. Obviously it'll very much depend on your cat and them basically, but this is just sort of an overarching what is kind of common within these cat breeds. So please let me know down below in the comments, what cat breed do you have? I actually don't know what Leah is. I think he's just a cat. I actually don't know what kind of breed he is. He's a little bit of an older cat. He's a senior cat. I think he's about 11 or 12. And he lost his first ever fang tooth the other day. So we keep catching his lip gets caught and it's quite funny, but bless him. So yeah, so he's now lost one of his big fangs, bless him. But yes, let's just get started. So as we all know, a pet cat is very much a part of the family, so you very much want to make sure that you are aware of any particular health issues that may be common within your cat breed, because these are things that you can easily mention to your vet when you go and just say, I know that this is quite common with this type of cat, could you please check this out? And you can just keep an eye on things like that. And obviously the earlier that you pick up on different signs, the earlier they can be treated and the most likely they will be to live a long and happy life. So you want to make sure you're keeping your eye on different things with your cat. Now obviously some breeds are more likely to suffer from certain health issues than others, so we've put together this little guide just to help you guys understand the kinds of cat things that you might need to deal with, you might need to look out for. So the first one is the Bengal cats. Now these are beautiful cats. I've seen so many pictures of them and videos of them. They are absolutely gorgeous. They're really, really piercing eyes. Very, very popular cat breed. Now the Bengal is a fairly new breed that first came about when the Asian leopard cat was crossed with a domestic cat. The hope was to create a breed that would be a great family pet but with exotic looks of a wild cat, which I could definitely vouch for. Now in terms of different things and issues they are prone to having, they are prone to have eye problems like glaucoma, cataracts as well, so just keep an eye on your cat's eyes, make sure they're getting checked out. You can even check them out easily yourself as well. Make sure you're checking out for any infections and abscesses from different wounds that they have. If they get cut or anything like that, make sure you're taking care of that to make sure no infections happen or anything like that. And they also suffer from kidney disease and cystitis as well. Now the next one is a ragdoll. Now the ragdoll is such a beautiful cat. If you've seen them before, they look like the perfect cat. If I ever think of a cat, apart from my obvious video, I would also think of a ragdoll. They are just beautiful. Now the ragdoll cat is beautiful with blue eyes and silky long grey coat, often with markings on the face, ears and legs. Now because of the length of the fur, you obviously have to do a lot of grooming with them, which can be a plus, can be a negative, so it depends on you. I love the look of like a really, really fluffy cat. Rio's quite fluffy, aren't you? A little bit of a fluffy cat, but he's not as fluffy as, say, a ragdoll. So one of the health issues that ragdolls can develop is hypertrophic cardiomyopathy, which is something that you definitely need to keep a close eye on, especially if you're going to the vets. Just make sure you're asking them to kind of look into this a little bit for you. Am I in focus? The other one is kidney disease as well with this cat. So again, just some things to keep an eye out. Maybe look at the different symptoms of these certain diseases, just so you can keep an eye on if you do have a ragdoll. And the next one is the British Shorthair cats. These are very, very popular, especially here in Britain and across the world as well. Very, very popular in many, many households. The British Shorthair is a fairly large breed of cat with rounded features. It has a short coat, which that comes in a huge variety of colours and patterns. It's a pretty low maintenance cat as it requires grooming less than once a week and is very active. The breed doesn't demand a lot of attention and is genuinely quite quiet as well. Now the British Shorthair genuinely do has a really, really good health, but there are a few conditions that it is prone to, developing polycystic kidney disease, which is something you need to look out for, as well as hypertrophic cardiomyopathy as well, which is very similar with the ragdolls too. So again, just keep an eye on these things. But that is it for some common health problems that can develop with certain cat breeds. Please let me know down below in the comments what cat breed you have, maybe their name as well. I love learning a little bit more about who is watching our videos. Don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Of course, don't forget to comment down below and don't forget to subscribe as well if you haven't already, and I will see you all next time. Bye.